Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. As a chef and living in the eastern part of Long Island, it offers me the opportunity to visit many of my local farms and get produce not only just in the summer and the late fall, but also in the earliest of spring. And what I have here is something that might not be immediately familiar because it's only available for a few weeks of the year. And it's called a scape, which is actually the green shoot from hardneck garlic, which is grown here on the eastern part of the island. And in the earliest of spring, as the shoots come up out of the ground, they trim off the greens to allow the head to become a little bit more robust and larger in size. Now, the scape can be cooked and prepared in a lot of dishes that you would typically use: garlic or green onions, scallions, soups, casseroles. But because it's only available for a few weeks of the year, you either have to jar can them or do what I'm doing today and prepare a pesto. And the pesto, I've chopped some of the scapes, the end of the scapes. This is the flower end that comes up first. And what I'll do is break off the woody end and cut off the end, much as you would on a stalk of asparagus. Chop it up. I'm gonna add in a few pieces of garlic. And for my scape pesto, I'm going to add in some almonds, some slivered almonds instead of pine nuts. Just to give it a little nuttier taste. You could use walnuts. You could add hazelnuts, almonds, basically any type of nut is fine. So we'll grind that up until it's pulverized, it's small, and the aroma is absolutely tremendous, not only just with the regular garlic, but you can really get almost like an aromatic spring flavor with it. I'm going to add in a little spinach, which will just help pick up the color from the scapes. And I'll add in a few leaves of basil. And what's nice is, you know, basil is typically a summer herb and might be in your garden quite extensively in the summer. But when preparing pesto, it scapes earlier, you know, you're not going to have as much basil, fresh basil around, so you don't really need as much. If you were making a regular pesto all with basil, you would need, you know, baskets of it. So the scapes really helps out wonderfully. I'll put in a pinch of red pepper flakes, and then a couple pieces of Parmesan Reggiano. Just break up a couple of the cubes and add it in. And just pulse it slightly. And then we're going to want to stop because I want to add in a couple small ice cubes, or you could add in one ice cube. And basically what the ice is going to help here is to help keep it cool. As the friction takes place and blends in the spinach, the scapes, the fresh basil, you don't actually want it to cook inside the food processor. So the ice actually helps keep it on the cool side. Begin to add in your olive oil. We'll add in about a half to three quarters of a cup. Stop. And just scrape it down. Make sure there's no large chunks of cheese. And the consistency that you want with it is to actually be like a sauce consistency or a little bit smooth. Keep adding our olive oil. And again, the ice has kept it on the cool side and kept the leaves from actually cooking with the friction. And basically, that's all you want. You want it to be on the runny side and be able to pour right out into your bowl. So the scape pesto is going to be a key ingredient in the next part of our dish. Of course, you could use that for pasta or anything you would traditionally use for a pesto, but I'm making a fondue. And This fondue is going to be a little bit of a different spin than the one you might think of immediately of the fondue of the 60s, where you have that brightly colored pot with all the forks with the different colored handles, and you put cubes of bread on it and dip it in, and hopefully nobody double dips, right? So with this fondue, it will start with about a cup of white wine. I'll hold a little bit extra just in case I have to adjust the consistency at the end. And what I have here is some fresh peas, some beautiful fresh garden peas. Again, wonderful in the spring, readily available to early summer. And then of course in the fall, they come right back at you. So just shuck in about a cup of peas. And we'll let that begin to steep with the white wine. And then we'll get to the part of the fondue, which is a little more typical. I have here two types of Swiss cheese. This is an Emmental Swiss. They're both hard cheeses. And the second one is a Gruyere, okay, which is more typical from the Austrian side. And with both of these cheeses, I just want to cut them down. So you need about a cup and a half of cheese. You want to just steep the peas, and you're getting a little bit of the flavor from the fresh spring peas. And you want to make sure you don't overcook them because you want them to be a bright green color within the base of the fondue. We'll put in about 3/4 of the cheese first. Whip that in, and you can see it getting very, very milky. The peas are still brightly green. Okay, now to finish off the fondue, I serve it in individual ramekins. So each guest actually has their own dish. And very simply, just a few blanched string beans. You could put mushrooms in here, a couple pieces of spinach. And this makes a nice cocktail dish or even as a starter. A couple pieces of fresh spinach. A couple pieces of bread in each dish. Take a couple nice spoonfuls of the pesto. And you notice I'm putting it in at the very, very end because I have all those delicate herbs, the scape, the basil. The spinach, and I just want to finish it off. Cheesy goodness, the pesto from the scapes, absolutely incredible. So there you have it, find ways to prepare cheese, my appetizer and dessert cheese boards with savory and sweet sides, a gardenscape pesto, an ideal addition to an updated take on fondue. I'm George Hirsch. Remember, if I can do it, you can do it. See you next time.
For more on recipes, entertaining lifestyle tips, TV series blog, and selected video clips from today's show, join me at chefgeorgehirsch.com.